It's La Jolla's Man About Town, Kurt Yuli Kinsey with Cold Anchor right here in La Jolla. And I'm so excited to be here at Sugar and Scribe, located at 7660 Fay Avenue. And it's right on the corner of Klein and Fay. And I'm with Chef Maeve. Maeve, thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for coming. I'm glad you're here.
So tell us a little bit about you and how you started Sugar and Scribe.
Sure. So I was actually living in Los Angeles when my husband was promoted to San Diego.
Okay.
And I came to San Diego and I really, really wanted an amazing piece of pie.
Right.
And I just couldn't find it anywhere. I was like, where's all the great bakeries? And having lived in all of Europe and grown up in Cincinnati and New York, like, we live on bakeries. And certainly our bakeries were a little bit different to what I found in California, in that a bakery is also a restaurant. It's not just sweets.
Which I just found that out, because I was expecting it just to be a bakery.
No, yeah. So a lot of people think, like, oh, Sugar and Scribe, croissants, or cupcakes.
Right.
But actually, we have an entire full menu.
Right.
And
I'm going to speak to that, because I ate breakfast here last week, and it was the single most best breakfast I've had at a restaurant.
Yeah, it's really great. So I've won Best Bakery 6 years in a row,
right,
for San Diego, but we're catching up and people are really starting to see that our full menu is on point.
Right.
I have amazing chefs here, so, you know, it's not just me.
Okay.
It's an entire team of deliciousness.
Speaking of that, how many people do you have?
We have 42 staff members.
Wow.
I have an amazing chef de cuisine, Jocelyn. Mwah, love her. I have an amazing executive pastry chef, Daniela. Mwah, love her. Then we have Ray, who's by far one of the best cake decorators, I would even go to say, like, within the U.S.
That says a lot.
He's here,
yep.
And that says a lot because I'm a cake decorator as
right.
well. We have the best baristas. I'll take anybody's barista any day of the week they want to throw down against mine. Bring it.
That's
I got
challenge.
The best ones. I do. So we are a disorganized, dysfunctional, loving, immensely culinary-driven family.
Right. Fantastic. And so if you recognize Chef Maeve, she was on Food Network's Holiday Baking Challenge.
Championship,
yes. She's our champion. How did that change your business, your life?
I would say that it changed it in only all positive ways. We were already an established business and already established here in La Jolla.
For how long?
Sugar and Scribe had already existed for 4.5 years.
Okay.
And we had been in La Jolla already for about a half a year. And
okay.
it was doing really well. And I couldn't be more thankful, actually, to La Jolla.
Yeah.
I have never been embraced by such a wonderful community.
Isn't it, though?
Yeah, I mean, they have really taken me in as if, like, I was a native child.
Right.
So I have had the most wonderful experience of La Jolla. I know it can be hard for businesses, but I love La Jolla.
How
I love
you,
the locals. I love them all.
Where were you before that?
Before I was in Pacific Beach.
Okay.
And I think that what we're trying to do is, you know, I'm trying to be the Cartier of breakfast.
Right.
And I'm trying to be like a Harrods food court in
yep.
some ways. And I think that that was a challenging thing for what we were trying to do in Pacific Beach.
Right.
Whereas La Jolla has such an unusual demographic.
Doesn't it though?
From world travelers to just people who just love food.
Right.
And so people who love the arts.
Yes.
Can't wait for the Conrad Center. That'll
yep.
be great for us. Their people are my people. So I think all these are good things. And then with Food Network hit, what I found was that it really helped us with the people from outside of California.
Sure.
It helps bring people from Arizona and Washington and Oregon. And so I'm sure I'm not a lot, maybe just a little of the tourism pool,
yep.
but I feel like I
So that was
put
a question that I had
bit.
For you. So as you can see, we're full. It's a busy, busy
yeah.
day.
Yeah.
It's lunchtime. If you were to probably take a poll, because you've got your pulse on who's here, would you say that the majority of these people are locals?
The majority is locals.
Local.
For sure, yes. I am definitely more a locals-run restaurant and business, especially the bakery side.
Okay.
I'm going to do your wedding.
Yep.
I'm going to do your kids' first birthday. I'm going to do a smash cake. I'm going to get them when they graduate from high school.
I saw your graduation cake.
And then from there. So that's the part of being a bakery that makes me part of your family.
Sure.
I know your special moments.
Right.
You call me when you're late and you forgot, you know, your anybody's birthday, and I'm there to deliver for you. But I am also I'm trying to help bring people to La Jolla, and to the beautiful community that we have here.
Yes, and me too. That's
I kind
we're
of
doing.
Gushy, but I really love La Jolla. I do.
I do too. That's great. So baking is that's your passion.
That is where I am. And baking doesn't have to mean sweet.
Right.
You know, baking just means from an oven. That's
right.
what it means. And I love any sort of oven.
And what is your
five
ovens?
Yeah.
Here at home?
Here.
Okay.
You're not even going to count my house because
okay.
there's more there.
What's your favorite menu item right now?
So I am an emotional eater.
Okay, me too.
So, okay, so when I'm really hungry and I've worked like a 15-hour day and I just need to zone out and be me, I actually go for the smothered and covered. It reminds me of a really glorified Waffle House rendition. And I'm okay giving them credit because I love the Waffle House. And it's just homemade chicken gravy. We get our chicken sausage from homegrown.
Okay.
No GMOs, local, nice. Go business to business.
Yep.
And it covers potatoes and cheese and has bacon in it. And our bacon is also from a local butcher.
Yep.
And we cut it thick. So I really love that one. My favorite salad, bar none, is the arugula.
Okay.
But our best selling is definitely our chicken avocado with the homemade lemon.
Very California.
Yeah, it's very California. Yeah. But in 2 weeks, new menu items.
Okay.
We're coming out with a new list of tartines.
Okay.
So if people don't know, they're kind of like very beautiful open-faced sandwiches.
Okay.
And we're doing fun things with burrata and apricots. It's stone fruit season, but we're also going to be offering more savory versions with Haas avocado and ricotta, and that's going to be fabulous with a pan-seared prosciutto.
So I just need to pull up my sleeping bag.
Yeah, so I'm really super excited.
Yeah.
And then later in the summer, for our next menu change, and this will be a really big one, and I can't wait to see how Little Boy reacts to it, we're going to be doing something very, very special with a crab cake.
Ooh,
not just your normal.
Okay.
It's going to be a wow.
Love it.
Yeah.
So since you were looking for pie, I'm assuming you have a signature pie.
We do.
Yeah. And so what's in season right now? What are you doing?
So right now it's stone fruits and berries.
Okay.
So we're doing a ginger peach that is actually, we put it in jars, peaches, and we soak it with rum and ginger and cinnamon until the peaches really break down, and then we slice them up, core them out, and then we fill up your pie, and so that's called the braised peach. It's delicious.
And you sell the whole pie?
We sell the whole pie. I don't do slices.
Okay.
I do whole pies. And the only kind of like persnickety thing about my pies, I always tell everyone, is I bake to sell.
Okay.
So I'm only going to do a limited amount per day. I want them to sell out. There's no preservatives.
Okay.
It's from local growers. Everything I do is fresh. So there's no frozen, there's no anything.
Farmer's market here on Sundays?
I do. And actually, I use specialty produce a ton.
Okay.
Julia's specialty.
Yep.
Kisses and hugs to you because you save my butt all the time. So
nice.
Yeah, it's great.
Awesome. What are the hours of operation here?
It's super simple to remember. We are 7 to 4 Monday through Saturday, and 7 to 3 on Sundays. Kitchen always closes a half an hour, obviously, before close.
Right. Reservations?
We don't do reservations, but certainly on the weekends when we are, you know, huge waits, call us when you're 20 minutes out, get on that list.
Oh, nice. That's a very good idea.
Yeah.
I like that.
So, yeah, it's even great for locals.
Facebook?
We're on Facebook, we're on Instagram, we're on Snapchat, we're on Twitter. Then there's Chef Maeve.
Right.
I tell you all my upcoming shows. There's something fun coming out with somebody that I can't say anything about, but it's really fun. That's in October.
Yep.
And then there's also Sugar and Scribe.
Right.
But Sugar and Scribe is like Chef Maeve's baby.
Okay.
And all of my employees are my children.
Perfect. Last question, and that is, since you love La Jolla, you've probably had a chance to go and be a patron at some other places, not just restaurants but stores. What's your favorite place to go here in Loyola?
Okay, for food, I have a Thai.
Okay.
Spice and rice.
Okay.
Their Thai chicken fried rice. Ask for the original way.
Okay.
It's like getting the secret sauce. Okay. Ask for the original way.
Right.
And put an offensive amount of their chili flake ginger sauce on it.
Okay.
What just happened? It's so hot. It's so delicious. I need it.
Love it.
And then I absolutely love and adore Prep Kitchen.
Prep Kitchen, and that is
Just up the street from me.
Yes.
And my husband thinks that their burger is absolutely phenomenal.
Okay.
But I just really love how they have seasonal menus.
Right.
I love their preparation. I love their atmosphere. I find it extremely inviting. It reminds me of so many places that I went to in New York.
Yep.
They kind of like have Brooklyn cool feel.
Nice.
So those are
my
favorites.
That's next to Juice Caboose, right on that side.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Huge fan of them. And then I think that Nectar should ask me to be an investor because I drink that much turmeric lemonade.
Okay.
I'm surprised I'm not orange. I could be like an Oompa Loompa.
You're super healthy though.
Yeah, I am a little healthy.
You're working 15-hour days. You got to take care of yourself. So.
And then my other thing is Cosbar. Because Cosbar is this fabulous, it's on Girard,
okay.
It's down the street. And John is the general manager of Paz Bar, and he's really great. So I spend a lot of time on television, and I do shows that not all air here, then shows in Ireland and stuff. And coming from the background of actually being in the kitchen and being an athlete, makeup and hair, not a skill set, as we can see today when I don't meet with John. My hair looks like Mufasa, and God bless if I don't stab myself in the eye. I am the least feminine cheek chick that there is. I didn't even have my hair done for my own wedding. Like, I'm a wreck of a woman. However, John and Cosmar always sees
me. And your husband loves the way you kick in the kitchen.
Yeah, well, that's it. So the only reason I actually think I landed an amazing husband, and he is the light of my life, is that I can cook, because the rest of me is a wreck. I'm not a good wife at all.
Don't believe it.
But I'll bring it back at breakfast. Right. Yeah.
Fantastic. Well, this is Maeve, Chef Maeve, Sugar and Scribe.
Love
you. Hope you enjoy our episode and go out and take advantage of those other places that she recommended. We'll be seeing those soon, and then we're going to show you some B-roll footage of this place. And come in and see us.
Come in.
Lohia's Man About Town signing off. Have a great day.
Bye.